Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here I ask the question. If x equals square root of 2 minus square root of 3 divided by 2, what is the value of the sum of two radicals? If we just directly plugging x values into this sum, it will make this sum more complicated. Notice that the two radicals are reciprocal. Therefore, we consider the sum square first. Expanding the sum square, we have x squared over 1 minus x squared plus 2 plus 1 minus x squared over x squared. Simplify the right-hand side and add 1 on the numerator of the first term and a minus 1 at the same time. The purpose is to simplify this part. Then we have 1 divided by 1 minus x squared. Minus 1 minus x squared divided by 1 minus x squared, which is 1. We have 2 here. And we have 1x squared here and minus 1. Continue to simplify this part. We have 1 over 1 minus x squared plus 1 over x squared. We consider the common denominators of the right-hand side. Then we have x squared plus 1 minus x squared divided by x squared times 1 minus x squared. X squared minus x squared are canceled out, equals 1 over x squared times 1 minus x squared. Come back to the given condition. X equals square root of 2 minus square root of 3 divided by 2. We take squares on both sides. We have x squared equals 2 minus square root of 3 divided by 4. From this expression, in addition to have x squared, we also need 1 minus x. 1 minus x squared equals 1 minus 2 minus square root of 3 over 4. We simplify this part. We have 2 plus square root of 3 over 4. Now we are ready to plug in the two numbers into this expression. Simplify this part. We have 16 over 2 squared minus square root of 3 squared, which is 16. X divided by square root of 1 minus x squared plus square root of 1 minus x squared divided by x squared equals 16. We don't need a square. Taking square roots on both sides of this equation, we have the final answer is square root of 16, which is 4. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.